In the prophecies, the Messiah who is promised by Hazrat Rasulullah as Isa ibn Maryam, he would descend. If this is what he meant literally, to be the same Messiah as was born at the end of Moses' Ummah, if this is the meaning, then the prophecy, the whole prophecy has to be taken literally. And all that is mentioned in the prophecy must be taken literally. Jesus is literal, Dajjal is literal, his donkey is literal, and what the donkey does should also be understood literally. Because it is not metaphor then. But if Jesus is metaphorical, the one who would come in spirit but not in person, then the entire prophecy should be understood in its metaphoric concept or message, not literal message. God is speaking in parables and metaphors, like Jesus Christ spoke in so much in parables. So the Holy Quran also employs parables. In this case, let me turn to the hadith you are referring to and remind you that neither Jesus is literal, nor Dajjal is literal, nor his donkey is. All the prophecies have to be understood and interpreted, and there must be a spiritual key with which we solve the prophecy and understand the message. Jesus is mentioned to descend in the latter days. Among his functions would be to kill Dajjal. Yaqtulul Dajjala. Wa yaqtulul khinzir. To kill the swine. And yaksilul silin. To break the cross. These are the three functions mentioned in this prophecy. Now, if the Dajjal means the same single joint-like figure who would be so huge that while standing on the ground, his head would be above the cloud lines. He would have one single eye. That would be blind. One eye would be blind. The other eye, the single left eye, would be very bright. So bright and so powerful that it would be able to X-ray what is underneath the earth and see the treasures lying under the earth. Now we believe that this is all metaphors. Neither one single person is mentioned as Dajjal, not real swines are mentioned in relation to Jesus' killing them, not real crosses made of stone or jewels and things are meant to be literally broken by Jesus Christ. Neither Jesus is literal nor these things are literal. So our interpretation is very consistent in this regard. We believe that Jesus is a spiritual representation of the old Christ, not literal. Not that he would return himself. When he comes, his main task would be to break the cross, which means to break the central argument of Christianity in favor of Trinity. This is cross. This is a symbol of cross, Trinity. So he would come and break the cross spiritually, in the sense that he would provide such powerful arguments against the Trinity as if cross is broken. Not literally, of course. When it is said that he would kill the Dajjal, it doesn't mean he would murder him with his sword. It simply means that the influence of the Dajjal would begin to wane out from the time he comes, and he would gradually dissipate, and new things would appear. There will be a revolution in the world taking place. These old huge powers will gradually lose their strength. So by the Dajjal we mean great Christian powers. The symbol of Christian powers is Trinity, cross, eating of swine. So in every way you look at it, The finger is pointing at the same people, that is, in the latter days, according to this prophecy, the Christian world will become so powerful that they will rule the entire world. And this would be the stature of Christianity, as symbolized in a great giant against whom nobody has any power. This giant is described in the Hadith as conquering every land, every people of the world. And in the rise of the West, in the current history, or the previous history, you find not an inch of land left unoccupied, ungoverned, by the superior might of the Western nations. There was a time, you know, where either it was ruled by the British, or by the Russians, or by the Germans, or by any other Europeans, or even Americans. But the whole globe fell under the sway of Christian powers. This is exactly what has been prophesied by Hazrat Muhammad regarding the advent of Dajjal. What is the main instrument in the hands of Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam through which he broke the cross into two? His claim that Jesus died a natural death. He did not die upon cross. And he died like an ordinary prophet of Allah, so he was not little son of God. If you believe in this, if enough proof is provided to you to believe in this, then cross is broken. There is one meaning, the meaning we prefer. If you reject that meaning, then the only alternative left to you is that meaning which is presented and adhered to very tenaciously by the anti-Ahmadiyya mullahs all over the world. They say, no, this is nonsense. We will not permit you to interpret the Holy Quran sensibly. What right have you got to interpret the Holy Quran or the Holy Hadith sensibly? Let us follow the literal meaning exactly, verbatim, as it expresses itself. But then follows the greater absurdities, compounded absurdities. They say Jesus would come, say, after 2,000 years. So far he has not come according to them. Then what would he find? He would find a Dajjal, a huge giant, the dimensions of which are so incredible that even such a man is not mentioned in fairy tales or tales of the jinns. No giant will you find mentioned as big and as huge. So he said there would actually be a giant born. And he would travel the whole earth and conquer every nation and every people. Now what would be the mode of his travel? How would he travel so fast? Would he run very fast? They say no. The Hadith also tells us that a donkey would be born to carry this huge giant. And the donkey would be as huge, matchingly, as the giant himself would be. The distance between two ear lobes would be 105 feet. And as far as his hugeness is concerned, he will carry the giant on his back to travel around the world. But at the same time, there will be side openings in his belly. And he would stop at stages. And it would be announced that the time for the giant to depart has come. So many minutes left, come and get in. And people would rush in and enter the belly of the giant from the side openings, from both sides. Strange sort of giant, with a strange sort of donkey to help him. And then the Hadith tells us that this donkey would not eat fodder. It would be a fire-driven donkey, fire-powered donkey. It would eat only fire to get its energy to move, to function as a life thing does. So as against the fodder-driven donkeys, a new donkey would be created for the sake of Dajjal, which would be fire-powered. This is very clear. Now, what would be the speed of that donkey? How fast would he carry that giant and the people in his bellies? The speed, according to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, would vary from land to sea to air. On the land, that donkey would cover the same distance in 1 hour. So instead of 30 days continuous journey, he would carry his passengers to the destiny within 1 hour. That fast will he move? Will he move only on land or also in the sea? The hadith says, yes, he would be able to swim on the oceans and he will not drown. The same donkey, the same fire-powered donkey is mentioned in the tradition to go across oceans and he would not sink. But he would carry even greater loads on his back. It is said that it would be the same donkey employed by Dajjal, the power which owns it, to transport wheat and other food aids to poorer nations, as if that donkey would be carrying mountains of food on its back when it swims in the ocean. And that food would be sent not to the poor people of all the world indiscriminately. That would be sent only to those who bow to the Dajjal and his supremacy. So the aid would be tied, would be linked. It would not be free aid to Ethiopia, for instance, when it dies of hunger, or to Somalia when it dies of hunger, because they would not be tied up with the American policies. That aid would be tied only to those, to the condition that they accept the supremacy of their master, the Dajjal, and then they will be provided with food, otherwise not. Now, this donkey would do this task according to the traditions. But this is not all the surprise for us. The Holy Prophet says that donkey would be able to fly above the cloud line, because he says at times he would make a jump as big as if his one foot was in the east and second would be in the west. So any aeroplanes which takes off from India, from Africa, from Pakistan or any other eastern countries and lands either in Europe or in America, continues to declare the truth of the Holy Prophet, that this is what he envisioned, this is what he saw beforehand. And I am here as an evidence that he was a true prophet of Allah. His prophecies were right. That is when it is interpreted our way. When you believe that the prophecy was metaphorical, it didn't mean a literal donkey. It meant a mode of travel only. A mode of travel which would be a land mode of travel, sea mode of travel, air mode of travel. But the common feature would be that all these modes will be fire-powered as against the food of donkeys. So this is again a metaphorical issue. But not so with the other mullahs. They said, no, don't be absurd. When Hazrat Rasulullah said such a donkey would be born, believe it would be born. If not today, tomorrow. You see a huge donkey born out of a weakling mother, ordinary mother, donkey, who would grow to this abnormal size. And then you will see the giant also appearing from nowhere. And then he would start riding and there will be opening made on the side of the donkey. All these modern planes will be abandoned, all the trains and the ships will be abandoned. A new mode of travel will be provided to mankind. They will always prefer to sit in the belly of the donkey. This is what they would have. Which side are you on? Consult your conscience, which is a greater tribute to the greatness of Allah Muhammad. This meaningful interpretation or that nonsensical interpretation which puts to shame even the first fairy tales, if taken literally.